Well, now there are two books about Allan Carlson. The first one, the idea of the first one was that I wanted to reveal the shortcomings of the 20th century. For that, I needed a guide. And if you are to be a guide over a whole century, by necessity, by the end of the century, you have to be quite old. And then I felt the urge after two or three books in between that I would like to reveal present time as I did with the 20th century. From the beginning, it wasn't meant that Allan should do comeback, but the guy I picked in his place didn't deliver. So there he was. I tried Allan in different situations and he showed me that he deserved a comeback. It could be that I care very much about the development. I worry very much about the development of the world. To stand it all, I use humor. And I truly believe that if we could pour humor and self-distance over the heads of world leaders, the world would be a better place. So humor is my weapon, and I hope, if you allow me to be pretentious, I hope that by using humor, I kind of educate one or two. And if so, then I'm happy. I say that, but I also add that I think I finished like this, that, hey guys, it could have been worse, and maybe it is. So I'm afraid that I'm very close to the truth. Here I am, like 16 million books later. Of course, it's nothing you can grasp. It's beyond any imagination. I had a dream of one, getting published, and two, maybe selling 3,000 copies, because if I did, the publishing house would ask me to write another novel. And instead it became 16 million and counting. That's something.